If I put $1 million on the table in front of you and said to tell me what the most powerful mid-size V6 powered sedan was in America, what would you say?
Nope.
Nope. Nope, you're still wrong. It's the Dodge Avenger. And no, if you got that right, you were cheating. One thing you've got to give credit to towards Dodge designers is they always try to work in sporty lines into their cars, and the Avenger's no different. You've got the iconic crosshair grille, this cool-looking sporty lower fascia, these blocky but aggressive-looking headlights up front. You're coming around, you sweep past the 18-inch wheels, down the side of the body, and you almost get a charger-like kink here in the rear three quarters. Overall, it's a sporty look, capped off by this spoiler that makes you think you're driving a quick car. Here is the reason you were wrong about my million-dollar question at the beginning. It's this 3.6-liter Pentastar V6 engine. It puts out 283 horses. That's why I said this is class-leading at the price. It gets 29 miles per gallon on the highway. We're talking about a car that starts at nearly $19,000 and gets nearly 300 horsepower. That's crazy in this segment. Remember that cheap computer chair you bought at IKEA? It did its job. That's what we have going on here in the backseat of the Avenger. My legroom is adequate, my headroom is adequate, so I'd be all right on a long trip or a short trip, but I'm not feeling very comfortable back here. It's all right for short term, but I think after a while, I'd start to go pretty tired. There's no surprises to be found up front here in the Dodge Avenger. The seat is as adequate as the rear seats, but thankfully, Dodge has fitted some upgrades to the steering wheel. You've got steering wheel mounted controls, you've got Bluetooth hands-free in here, you've got a USB kit, you've got a larger optional nav screen that's touch, and it works great and brings the sound system up a notch. Overall, it's merely okay in here. This car needs to be refreshed, and it can't be refreshed soon enough to go from merely okay to good. The interior is just mediocre, and the driving experience compounds that sensibility. We're talking about steering that is merely okay. It's responsive enough. It could be a little quicker to go with that sporty image outside. The brakes work. We wish they grabbed a little tighter. You're not gonna crash. They're fine. We just wish they were better. But there is a major bright spot, and it's under the hood, courtesy of that Pentastar V6. When you hit the gas, this thing takes off. The Avenger's a tough sell. It's still viewed as a mediocre rental car, but Dodge is working hard to make this thing better and better every year. And they've hit on a major point to that end, and we're talking, of course, about the engine. That's the reason you'd buy this car. Sure, the sporty good looks play into it, but the rest of it is just an okay factor, especially when cross-shopping against the very brutal competition. But when you think about it, if you want that power at this price, you get it for the engine.